choking on your words again. The secret's in your throat, and I really wish you'd say what you're thinking. We've been down this road so many times before. My stomach cannot take it. I've been killing time, you've been crossing lines. You say,
Get ready for this.
I'm taking out my dagger.
Just say it for me.
And now, live from Amateur Hour International Studios, welcome to Amateur Hour Commentary. Please welcome your host.
Welcome, everyone, to Amateur Hour Commentary. This is the Wolf Craze, and joining me for, what is this, two nights in a row now?
Rad, lucky me.
Damn. No, lucky us, dude. You guys killed it last night. I was just watching it today. Hold on, I got to mute Titch. I don't know why I didn't do that to begin with. Anyway, yeah, you guys killed it last night. Watching NWG go up against itself was kind of interesting. What did you think of last night's game?
I was very confused with all the NWGs. But other than that, it was really, really good. I was impressed with both teams. They did really good. Like I said, we pointed out a few little things that they had done that kind of, you could see how it weighed out the point system that came out last night, how they 9-3, but, both teams did really good.
Yeah, definitely. Some of them came down to like just the bitter end, like a couple of members were left alive and that was it, you know, really good, yeah. Really good fights. I enjoyed watching it. And, you and Timber, I mean, just. Well done. It was beautiful. But tonight, guys, we have Scrub Squad and Rain. For those who have been following us or those who have been following the NA division of Pro League, know that this is going to be kind of a rematch of the season. Highly anticipated rematch because Scrub Squad came in second last season and Rain came in first. So, but both are not faring too well this season, unfortunately.
Yeah, Rain in fifth place and Scrub Squad in 10th. Still plenty of time, though, because we're in week 6 of 11, so they can still pull it away, but oh, let the shit talk begin. Yeah, I love matches like this. It's so great.
Yeah, man. Oh, look, Titch is watching us. Yes, that is why we have some AHC Inception going on. Hey, Titch, how you doing, man?
Titch was my sponsor last night for whiskey and Coke. Wrong hand. Oh, and then man. You get to do the Rain thing.
Yeah. By the way,
yeah, the Rain man.
Raise energy. Get it. AHC for promo code. Get you 15% off anything in the store. Link below. Check out the panels. Where's the poll? I'll get the poll together. I just got to log in. We got some time. I know Titch was updating his game. For those who haven't hopped on Firewall in a couple of days, apparently there's an update. Rad, you know more about the update. Do you know what's been going into it at least?
So now when you get to play in the, you know, wait out in the lobby for 20 minutes for a squad to come together, you can now see snowflakes, and there's Christmas trees and presents. And I think one was actually under the tree for Chuckamus Prime because it was all zebra looking like. but yeah, so it was a long, long update. It's, you know, that time of year, and I'm sure we'll get to see it for the next 3 months.
Yeah. Yeah. And they were a little late with the Halloween patch, you know, that came in, I think it came in what, a day or two before Halloween, and it lasted all the way through Thanksgiving. I don't know.
Yeah. Look, I ate turkey that day, and that night I had Black Widows waving around in my face. So I was ready for the update.
Oh my goodness. Before we go any further, why don't we give a shout out to everybody in chat. Raz, or as people know him now as Rob. Karen's here, Skulls, Walzer, Titch, Cinderella, thank you all for tuning in. If you have not yet chimed in, please do so we can welcome you formally. But without further ado, why don't we talk a little bit about the squads. We'll start off with the Scrub Squad, go over their roster and their stats a little bit. So the roster for Scrub Squad goes as follows. Titch as the captain, Karen, Hellrain, Jesse B. Truck, and Hemoglobin, Goatshaw, and DMRP. Looks like all of them are able to actually play, which is great, because sometimes, you know, when you add new people to your roster, you got to wait a few days before you're eligible. You know, I could talk a little bit about the Scrub Squad, having a personal relationship with them. They're a solid team, but this season they've been struggling a little bit. And, you know, you can't really blame it on any one person or any one member of the team. I think just some nights they show up really well, and then it just kind of falls apart, or there's communication that goes wrong. Something happens. Truth be told, they are still very, very solid team. I can't get my detailed list to show up. Hold on, I gotta open chat because I want to go over how well they've been doing this season. As Rad said, they're currently sitting in 10th place. If we look at what they've been doing over the past 5 weeks, they went up against Sour Gummy Worms in their first week, tied 4-4. They had one ace. In week two, they went up against the Looney Tunes and lost 1-7. That was a big loss. A lot of that people attribute to not just the Looney Tunes themselves, but also their new squad mate, Porky Pig. Some people may know him by another name, but he's been a solid addition to their team, and they've been really killing it this season. Round three, they went up against NWG The Family. They came out victorious with a score of 5-3. No aces, unfortunately, so that's points lost. Round four, they went up against Meatpack. Lost 3-5, but that's understandable because Meatpack is currently high up there in the rankings, and they're a really, really tough team. And last week in round five, they went up against the Killabees, who are currently sitting in first, I believe. Did I get that right?
That sounds right. It probably.
Probably is. And they lost 0-8, although those fights were really intense. So I got to give them credit where credit's due. I mean, going up against Killabees, current first place standing, and they really put up a fight. Did I just close out my Skype? I did.
No.
Crap.
Did you?
Technically I'm still here, but okay, here we go. Now I'm back up. Anyway, so that's the Scrub Squad. I wish them the best of luck. I don't have any predictions on how well they're going to do tonight, but they are going up against Rain, who is known to be fairly good. And speaking of Rain, why don't we send it over to Rad, who can talk to us about their roster and standings.
Rain's roster is Rogues, SRT, 8 Ace, Therm, Dermos, Buckaroo, FP Villain, Seemed a Good Idea, Waleed Ghost, Ablazon, and Chuckamus Prime. Chuckamus Prime being the whore of all tournaments. As far as all the fancy talk that Wolf just did, I don't have those stats because I'm not important enough for that stuff. But I would definitely say this is a very strong lineup. I've played with a bunch of these guys. Actually been in a tournament for like 1 point. Actually, it was like 0.8 of a match. But I love the guy anyway, SRT. Shout out. No, really strong lineup with these guys. I mean, it's going to be a very strong team to go up against with Rain. Going back over to Scrub Squad, I would totally just blame Titch. That's such an easy thing to do. He's the jackass that put his name captain next to there. So if any that look, at least Rain was smart enough to have a lieutenant. So if Rogues doesn't want to take any shit, you know how it rolls downhill.
It's true.
Yeah. So Titch kind of set himself up for this disaster, but still plenty of time. Love Titch. They can really pull out of it. They'll do it. Tonight's the night. I'm not actually following them tonight. I think Rain's going to get it, but maybe tomorrow night. Tomorrow night is the night. Not tonight.
I like your segment far better than I like my own, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Yours sounds way better, dude. So organized.
If you guys are interested in checking out what Rain's stats are, or at least knowing what they are in terms of week-by-week performance, for the most part, they're kind of split. They're a little bit 50-50. Their first week, they tied. The second and fourth week, they came out victorious against Sour Gummy Worms and NWG The Family. And in week three and week five, they lost to the Looney Tunes and Meat Pack. But again, it seems as though some of the better teams from last season are simply just losing out to the better teams of this season. So, I mean, is that, yeah, you know, I can't fault them for that. They're going up against Killabee's Meat Pack and even Click Clack. I mean, they went up against Click Clack in their first week, Rain did, that is, and tied them 4-4. I think they walked away with one ace. So they're performing fairly well, but you could definitely tell the difference between last season's talent to this season's talent.
New tactics. We discussed this last night about new tactics, how Firewall is the game that we've been all playing for over 2 years now, and how we all started off at one point. We got into a groove, and it seems like the teams and the particular people that excelled were the ones who were trying the new things, trying the different tactics. And that's why I said, like myself, I'm perfectly as one at fault to say that I am really bad about wanting to go to that one same spot every single time. We're defending on this round. This is what we do. And you got to sometimes think outside of the box, especially up against teams like Killabee, where they're constantly coming up with new ideas to come kill your ass. Mm-hmm. So it's new tactics, new ways. It looks like maybe some people got some new tricks up their sleeve.
Yeah, with the 2 years now that this game has been live, and it really, I could say it really hasn't slowed down. I mean, we've seen an active user base throughout the entire 2 years. And, you know, we used to see a rush tactic. You know, every team was always rushing, whether offense or defense, they just sprinted across the map. And we've also seen the meta change in terms of what gun is being used. I remember it was the HZU for the longest time. Were you a HZU user? Do you remember using that submachine gun, the HZU?
Oh yeah, just like it sucked. For me, it sucked. But I like again, I'm old school. I'm still doing CQB, which I've been like people are yelling at me about this. Like you're so old, you know. But Old Faithful, man, she never lets me down.
Right, and you know the legendary HZU is actually pretty decent. It's better than the generic HZU. Some would argue that they're pretty much the same, but I used to run HZU all the time, and I played with it a couple of times in the past 6 months. And the legendary is better in terms of performance, but it's still not any better than CQB or the classic Red K8 or what's that new one? Is it the custom Kruger? I think it is.
Yes. Yes.
And that's what I've been running with. So we've seen the meta change over the course of the 2 years from what gun is best, what tactic is best, what utilities are best. And they even removed the second revive dart. I mean, there was a period of time where the revive dart was like you needed it. And if you didn't run with it, you'd get shit for it. But now that they've reduced the number of revive darts, we've seen rushing come to a halt a little bit, and we've seen a change in tactics, as you said. And particularly in league play, things are so different. Now, I just want to talk about Killabee's for a moment. I talk about them pretty much every time I'm up here on the screen because holy shit. Killabee, first of all, you need to find another game to play.
Give us a chance.
Either that or just don't play these, run your own tournament and like have everyone try to compete to go up against you, because holy crap, you're incredibly skilled. Your entire team is skilled, but you in general, I mean, I've come across you in Publix multiple times, and I leave after one round because I'm like, I don't stand a chance. But they're just incredible. They came in here, and their performance has been far beyond expectation. I gotta pull up the stats again. Hold on. If we look at their current points, I mean, they are sitting at 77 points. So they're only according to the last update, I'm sure it's higher now because they just won last week with a score of 8-0.
Oh, that sounds right.
So that's what, 24 points. I can't remember how many aces, but 24 points at base. So 77 plus the 24. Well, you guys do the math. That shoots them really far ahead, and that's not even accounting for the aces. So they're significantly further ahead than like Meatpack or Click Clack at this point. By the end of week 4, they had 11 aces. So you tack on the aces that they got last week. I mean, they're just. It's almost as if they're playing in. They should be playing in a completely different league at this point. Not that you should. I'm glad that you're here, but like, crap. If they come back next season, it's gonna be tough.
Look, if Killaby was right in front of me right now, I'd say you're an amazing player. I've always wanted to play like with you instead of against you. But me personally, I'd also introduce Alvo to Killaby and tell her this is like the best fucking game ever. So. I still don't have Alvo, but for Killaby, I bet it would be great.
I don't know if you know FBI. Do you know that guy? I think he's from Hong Kong. He's played Firewall quite a bit. FBI. It's like a really long line of, have you ever come across that guy? No?
No, can't say.
I came across him in Firewall many, many times. Lags the F out all the time. But I think I heard that he was like from Hong Kong or something like that. So the connection obviously is an issue, but phenomenal player. Hopped in Alvo, saw him, kicked my ass there too. So clearly he's just a skilled player, but I've seen a couple of, Firewall folks over in Alvo and, you know, their performance isn't hindered at all by the change in pace. They're incredibly skilled. So we got to get more people. If you guys are interested, you can always join the Alvo Discord. If you don't have the link, I don't have the link personally right now. If someone in chat does have it, go ahead and share it. But you can also go to our Discord, which is in the panel below. Just click that image. We have a whole Alvo section, which has an invite link. You could just click on that and go straight to the Alvo Discord from there.
Shout out to Skulls and Killer Cam and also Jesse B. Truckin, by the way. Skulls.
Oh, a lot of stuff. Oh my goodness. What's up, Killa? What's up, Skulls? How you guys doing? What's up, Cougar? How you doing? Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Really appreciate it. Thank you for listening to all that jam right there. But let's talk about tonight's match a little bit and what we expect the score to be. Now, last night's match between the NWG team, that was the North American Firewall League. So there's their point scoring system is a little bit different. It's just however many games you win is however many points you get. Here, obviously, for those who are familiar with the Pro League, this is just going to be a reiteration for those who are new. This is how the point system works here. Every win gets you 3 points. If your entire team survives, following that round, you get an additional point, so you can get a total of 4 points overall. We're just going to capture the wins and number of aces and go on from there. But there's only 8 rounds that are played. And whoever comes out victorious in the end is whoever comes out with the most points. There have been a couple of matches, one of ours included, where we literally won by 1 point because we had one more ace than the other team. So anything can really happen at this point. We're going to take predictions on what the map picks are because there isn't a set map list. It's based on what the team feels they perform best at that time that the match starts. So in terms of score, Rad, who do you think is going to win and what do you think the score is going to be?
Ooh, I mean, just being real, I lean toward Rain, but both of these teams are just crazy good. I just being real with you, they're both really, really good. So I actually expect, even with the placement right now, because you've got one team that's in, what we said, fifth place, another team in 10th place, still really early, and it really depends on the lineup that you get too. I mean, if you could just imagine playing up against a Killer Bee team and then another Killer Bee, I mean, if you keep starting off like your first 6 weeks of 11, you're going to look horrible. So, I mean, unless you got your shit together. So, I just expect a lot out of both teams tonight. So I think it's going to be pretty evenly matched. One for one, someone's going to take it away, but I'm leaning more toward Rain.
Okay. You know, I on a normal night, I would say Rain, hands down. And I say hands down, not as a blowout, but as just historical context. They generally do come out victorious. I know Scrub Squad last season, they actually beat Rain in the early season because I think they played them in week one or week two, one of the first couple of weeks, and Scrub Squad beat Rain. But it wasn't until postseason that Rain actually came out victorious. But it wasn't by much.
Right.
So this season, tonight's match, I want to pull for Scrub Squad. They've had a few off weeks, but I think they're going to surprise us tonight. I think they're going to come out victorious with a 5-3 score. In terms of aces, I'm going to say at least two of their wins for Scrub Squad are going to be aces. And for Rain, they're probably going to have, I'm going to say two as well. I think they're going to, I think they're both going to get an even two aces for each team. But the Scrub Squads are going to win 5-3. That's what I predict. I'm never right on these things, so.
I was going to say, as far as the aces, maybe one on both teams. I mean, in my personal opinion, and I might be wrong, but I just don't see that. But we'll just have to let it play out. Plus, this would be like if we were taking bets or anything. You know how you want to get that inside information. So just in the chat here. I know that Jesse is not playing tonight, and I know Titch is very tired.
Oh, no.
So I know he's very, very tired. So, like, Titch is trying to – he's, like, stretching his eyes open right now. So he even said he's not going to play any games after this. He's going straight to bed. So just a little inside knowledge if you want to start placing your bets.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to have to – lean in on Rain.
I'm going to have to sign up my I'll be right back in chat, you know, by text soon, guys. I'm going to log into Age Commentary channel and get that pull up so you guys can place your predictions. In terms of map picks, what do you think we're going to see?
I'm sorry, I got distracted by Jesse Reed is writing, the guy replacing me hasn't reached level 50 yet. Sorry.
That's not
I'm still taking bets. The game has not started. Just saying. We want to bet some.
What's up, Frankie?
Some RAS drinks. So I'm sorry. What was your question?
It's okay. In terms of map picks, what do you think we're going to see?
Map picks. Don't expect to see Compound by the comments that I heard from Timber and by the way that it went last night. But I'm betting some post 15, some black site. You're going to try out the new maps. Think me personally, it would be hotel all day. That's kind of what I'm not exactly sure. I mean, I would definitely say containment would be a safe place to go. Hotel's always a safe place, but I do expect to see a couple of the new maps played.
I hope we do, and I hope we get an offshoot map like Hangar or Warehouse. I got that right once. I'm pulling for a second accurate prediction. But I definitely think if we're going to see District, that's going to be a Rain pick. Although the Scrub Squad is performing better on District, it's historically not the best map. But it looks like we're going into Post 15 to start out.
Is Rogues not streaming? Because I don't have... Yep, he is. Sorry.
I heard him ask where do we want him.
Sorry if you hear my clacking. I got a message, Chitch, that his game audio is not on. Pretty good spot for Scrub Squad here, though. Actually, if I'm post 15, if I were to get this particular spawn, I'd actually be pretty pleased.
Yeah, Rain's making their move toward the metal detector room, but it does look like they're using some Eagle Eye to get positions of the other team. And sticking together. Pretty close, so that's good.
Holy shit, no, he's heading back upstairs now.
Yeah, that's a guy who...
Got Wally, Buckaroo, Walzer. Rogues all playing for Rain right now. Solid team right there. What's up, Blair? How you doing? Welcome.
He might be, like, up in the bowl hiding.
Blair.
Everybody knows. Bingo.
Let's start pushing up. We got 350. Oh, he's beeping, I think. You hear that?
All right, so it looks like Rain is starting to make their move towards the double doors.
Doors open. Going in.
Yeah, check both doors if you can while lead.
That door has a motion on it, this front door.
Oh, all right.
Scrub Squad is going to play it from the outside of the metal detector room, from the back of the big open tank area. Lines of coverage.
Yeah, putting distance between them and the enemy is smart in this situation, especially if they're all pushing through the metal detector room.
Now, we saw this last night where this room could be just a potential bottleneck.
Wait.
Only two ways out. If you want to push through, last night there was a door blocker. That is a major difference, though. So, still some options here.
a little late opening the door there.
Should we pop this? Try to get some angles from there.
Ditch double downs.
Buckaroo down.
Now Rain going down. It looks like Scrub Squad is one by one being chipped away here. Member left alive.
Door! Oh, nice.
One more behind us. Behind
right
us,
here.
He's coming.
I believe that would be an ace for Rain.
All right, watch out for practice,
they make their
guys
way to get the hack on the laptop.
I might have been off on the aces. All right. I will admit that I can be a big person.
I just want to see if it's open.
I did not expect it. I really thought that Scrub Squad would hold their ground in the back, but it seems like they wanted to get that push in.
Yeah, a little late on the implementation of this strategy there. Titch was hoping Hellrain would be able to get the door open sooner. A wasted grenade, unfortunate, but it happens. You know, that spot is so tricky. It's a great spot to hold defensively, but at the same time, it's not so great because if it were me, if I were to make the choice in that particular spawn location, I would fortify that room. I would stay in that room because then they're all going to be bottlenecked into that one room. If you try to defend from outside that room, yes, people can come through there, but those aren't the only places that they can come. They can come through that room and those two openings. But as you saw, that there was a door right to the left of Titch. There's a couple of doors below them. There's a lot more opportunity for the attacking team to actually push on you, and that can cause a lot of chaos for the defense. But if you're in that room, there's only three directions that they can come from, in which you have four players. So there's at least one person watching each of those doors. And if you fortify it by using the door blockers, I mean, you're now just delaying game even more. So, I mean, in my opinion, that would be my strategy. But everybody does seem to sit out in the middle of the room on the walkways and try to defend from there.
Yeah, see, there's no way in hell I would take that approach as far as the metal detector room. At that point, I think, first of all, I don't like going inside of the metal detector room. I think that there's two ways, in and out. That's it. And the way that you came in, the double doors, obviously. But it's a bottleneck room. It's too small. Grenades have major impact when they're thrown in and you know, you're close by. So me personally, either I would do one of the two. Split up the squad, two on two. Two inside of the metal detector room. Two go underneath. So maybe they can try to breach the outside and cover the stairs from the left side of the metal detector room, and maybe take that approach, or all four stick together if they must, and find a better, more open path and say maybe the double doors underneath the metal detector room and take that approach. Still lots of angles that you can get shot at, but you have plenty of room to get around. Grenades can be thrown. You've got space to move. So metal detector room's just a little too closed off for me.
True. But I am curious in what the chat thinks, because many of the people watching are actual players themselves. What strategies have you guys used that you have found successful? If you were to pick one of those, would you pick one of those or would you take a different round? I am curious. It really comes down to what the team has practiced and what they're comfortable with. I'm much more comfortable with close quarters rather than the long shot, because I really don't have a good shot from a long distance, unfortunately. But I do like playing the little cat mouse game. If I am the last member alive, I tend to run so that I can pick them off one at a time. It's worked in some instances and not so much in others. So that's why, like, I prefer close quarters like that. But I see so many people running outside that room and with a lot of success. So we'll see what Rain actually does, as I'm sure with how spawns have been, we're going to see a mirror match here.
I hope so. We didn't get that in a couple rounds last night. I do hope they get the mirror match so we can see their angle.
I'm surprised no one has actually commented on our attire. I have to bring it up, man.
Yeah, it was blue hoodie Wednesday. So I don't know if anybody else got the message. I didn't get the chain, though. I, don't do that, but...
Okay, I can fix that. There we go.
Look at that. They're like brothers.
Hey, wait, where's my ball cap? Hold on.
Yeah, careful with that. Does it have a big A on front of it? Or
No, but it does have a big R because it's a Rays energy hat. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Nobody's perfect.
Oh, boy. All right, here we are. We are going back into post 15. Scrub squad on the offense.
Yeah, and not the same defense. This is actually a very nice setup for the defense. Laptops downstairs from right across from the corpse room. Looks like they're going to set up and possibly just stay down.
This is a secret.
That's the setup.
This particular defensive spot is a matter of angles. That position, you have very good angle positioning.
Yeah, you have a lot of good angles. You can even take this upstairs. We were a couple good door blockers, and you've got a nice position upstairs to hold. Rain is holding down tight. Scrub squad nearly there. We're about to see some contact.
Couple of concussion mines going off. If nothing else, that at least alerts them where they are in terms of positioning. But the scrub squad's a little bit split here. They are kind of running two and two, but going in opposite directions.
Rain's still just taking a good defensive spot, holding their ground.
It's the patience that's a challenge, isn't it?
There is, yeah. And Scrub Squad just got, we've got a player super red, both contacted each other. So.
Oh, fucker.
Very good trading. Yeah. Oh, and Buckaroo getting the shot from around the corner, eliminating Titch, and now it's a 4v3.
Watch your left. Buckaroo gets the revive. Oh, this is just a bottleneck. They're getting hit from both sides.
Oh, and here comes the rest of the scrub squad pushing in. Karen getting an elimination. But he goes down as well. Hellrain coming in to try to clean up. Buckaroo goes down. Same with Walzer. Hellrain cleaning house.
Holy hell.
Getting Hellrain and a Karen up is DMR peep. And somehow the scrub squad was able to clean house there. And now they are on time. All they have to do is get the jammer and get the hack, and they are good to go.
Yeah, it seemed like they might have been pissed off about the last round, or maybe some of my previous comments about them.
Guys, you should be paying attention to the game, not the commentary. Well played by the scrub squad, getting up on the board, though behind by 1 point. That could be the momentum that they need to carry them further into the next round, possibly get another victory.
Tight matches, just like what we said, tight matches. Yeah, are you still holding strong with Scrub?
Yeah. All they need is a little momentum, a little confidence. I'm starting to rethink about the number of aces. I think I was aiming a little too high for them, but I'm still confident they'll be able to walk away with a 5-3 victory here.
Right.
That was pretty strong defensive positioning for Rain, and the Scrub Squad was still able to take it with three members alive. Granted, it was almost one member left alive. So it was fairly close, but in the end, the Scrub Squad played very, very well in that round.
Yeah, 2 seconds in one round can literally make all the difference, and I think that we just got a good example of that.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they are going for Gauntlet. Might be wrong, but it looks like Gauntlet is going to be the next round.
I'm so glad Gauntlet. We feel the same here.
Well, I've always called Warehouse, like AKA Satan's asshole. Gauntlet, I have not come up with a name because it's so much worse. I just hate Gauntlet. Mm. Some people love it. They're really damn good at it. I'm sure that they love playing against me on Gauntlet. It's just not my thing. Can't get into it.
I'm just a moving mannequin when I'm in there.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. I kind of usually look like the mannequin after the nuclear blast and the old videos. That's usually what I look like after that match.
I have to give FCE credit where credit's due. The map is beautiful. I think the layout's really cool. I think it's a really well-designed map.
Yes.
I just can't perform well in Gauntlet. It's not... You know, I see so many teams, after having casted so many games, they take a position in the plane. And I always caution people, like, you know, that's... Sitting in the plane, if you're in the windows, you're leaving a very small portion of yourself, open to be shot. And that could result in a very quick down. But, you know, I'm proven wrong time and time again, as that defensive positioning has always helped a team dominate.
I agree. So here we go. Gauntlet, it is. Rain is making their way. Still using Buckaroo's using Eagle Eye, so he's going to get a position of where the other squad is.
Maybe you and I cover the long way? Yeah. I don't see anything to the left of the plane.
I don't see anything. Looking at Scrub Squad setup again. A bit split. Always got to be cautious with this. You got to be far enough apart that a single grenade won't get rid of your whole team, but you got to be close enough that you're in revive distance.
Yeah, Brain is definitely taking their time. Holding steady, checking out the Eagle Eye, checking every angle. Crook and Nanny. But yeah, they are still in place, checking things out. So
we got 3:30.
Patience is a virtue.
Yeah, there's like two towards the back and two towards the back.
All I need to do is get one member down, and that can change the momentum on their approach.
Well, thank God, Rain's finally moving. Here we go. Through the zigzag contact or visual on the bottom of the airplane here.
What sight is he using? Ugh.
All right, let's do it.
We are through.
All right, they're currently on the opposite side of the plane from Scrub Squad as they make their movement forward. There is a motion sensor on the base of the plane that Titch had put down.
Oh, one's in the back here.
Now they're opening themselves up to being shot.
To the left, to the back there.
As Scrub Squad draws fire, Titch trying to get an angle here, getting a couple of hits. Buckaroo downing Hellrain from the distance. Back, trying to go in for the revive, goes down himself. He is very well. Titch getting smacked with a couple of grenades. Rogue's getting it down. Titch has been eliminated along with a couple other members of the Scrub Squad. It looks like Hellrain's only been down now, fully eliminated. And there goes DMRP, the last member alive. That's it. Scrub Squad has been eliminated. It looks like Rain could get the victory here with another ace, as long as he can get that jammer. Which I don't know if there was jammer set. As I don't think the Scrub Squad usually runs with one, I'm going to be honest. In fact, I can't imagine them ever running with one. But there it is. Rain taking another win and another ace, increasing their lead pretty substantially.
Have you ever considered being an auctioneer? Just saying.
No. No, I can't. I when I was a kid, I used to try to talk really, really fast.
Like the Micro Machine guy.
Yeah. But it's way too hard.
Pretty good impression. I heard it. I'm just trying to read the screen, and you're just throwing them out really quick. So that's good. I can be the entertainment of this.
Oh, goodness. Yeah, that's why Titch always mocks me, because I don't let him get a word in edgewise. Otherwise. Cinderella says she may have a firewall addiction because she's watching two matches at once. Actually, that's very good. It's Razzle Dazzle against the Doggies. I'm curious to know what the stats are on that. That is a different league, of course, but two really good teams nonetheless.
Yes, firewall can be addictive. Have you ever watched it while you're going poop?
Yeah, I'm not ashamed to admit it.
Yeah. So, I mean, there's got to be a first step to everything. So that's when I knew.
And I usually pop it on when, in those uncertain times, you know, when you're just not sure, you're like, it could be or could not be. Let's just go make sure. And it usually relaxes everything and things happen. So it helps. It helps the magic happen.
One of my favorite things is to talk to somebody about Firewall who has no idea about Firewall or even owns a PSVR. So that is one of my favorite things.
I think that is a great point to make about Firewall, is that it is PlayStation exclusive. Unlike most games nowadays, they're trying to be all inclusive across various platforms, which I think is what the gaming industry needs. But PlayStation certainly needs some attention, and having a game like this is critical for its success. And it being 2 years old and still this good, I mean,
it's a good deal. Not bad for $40.
Hell yeah. It looks like we're having a very similar, I don't think it's a complete mirrored match, but it's pretty close, as Rain is taking position in the plane itself.
Yeah, there's already engagement. Buckaroo is down on the ground. The rest of the squad is still up inside the plane.
Walls are getting an elimination on Hellrain. Right now, Rain is one member up, 4v3.
Yes. Scrub is just trying to find that right angle.
It's going to be difficult because, as you had explained, Rain is just in optimal position. You got two members on the plane, at least one down on the ground. It looks like they've been traded there. Ack and Buckaroo both go down.
Walza revives Buckaroo.
Titch gets a Karen, and now everybody's back up. Rogue's downing DMRP.
And with the elimination,
Walzer goes down. Rogue's there for a quick revive. Grenades go out. He retreats. He's seeing a little bit of red. All members of Rain still alive, though.
Staying tight as a squad. It's a very different play. Three members staying tight, one going off for different, you know, ground angles.
And unsurprisingly, it's Buckaroo, and I say that because he's been their primary intel guy utilizing Eagle Eye, so that very well could be what he's doing there.
It probably makes sense. He just regrouped on the plane with the squad.
Only two members left for the Scrub Squad. They have a lot of work to do if they want to get a win here.
They are being patient, doing the cat and mouse game right now.
This is a tough alley to push through. It's usually best with smokes, but I don't know if the Scrub Squad really runs with smoke grenades.
Scrub Squad taking some hits there, but still up and going. Kill some time.
Yeah,
we kind of have to. We have no choice but to go that way.
Scrub squad killing time. Rain killing scrubs. I mean,
now Buckaroo went back down. Back down on the ground. Three in plane, one down on the ground. Taking more hits. God, they just got those angles, man. They've really got them down well.
So, they do. And trying to cross that alley the way Titch is right now, it's not going to be possible without smokes. Their best option is to loop back around, which it looks like that's what they're doing as Ak and Titch make their way all the way around, trying to go to the other side of the plane, perhaps.
That's maybe what I would do. Different approach. When they know where you're at, it's time to move. Unless you feel no like you've got an advantage by gunning them down, but it's time to move at that point.
Right, exactly. Yeah, what is it? Idiocy is defined by doing the same thing over and over and expecting the same results. You got to switch it up at this point. And they now have intel on cameras, which is going to work in their benefit. Titch trying to peek around the corner. Wally goes downs Titch, and it looks like Ak has also been downed. And that's it. Scrub Squad has been eliminated. Rain with a successful defense and another ace.
Another ace. Wow. Dude, I was way off on this, man. Way, way off.
I was initially going to predict that Rain was going to have all their wins were going to be aces. And I'm like, no, that's not even going to be possible. But, man.
Look, when you've got the shooters and you know where the angles are, you pretty much know where they're going to, what the other team is going to do. This is where we were talking about. You've got to reiterate. You have to regenerate some ideas, basically. Different approaches. If as soon as they were fired on, I think the whole squad should have maybe taken a different approach, or maybe it just happened too fast for them. Who knows? But they definitely had some good angles.
It's tough for a team like Rain or some of the top, more top end teams, the ones that you always see performing really, really well, because sometimes in situations like that, my recommendation would be, okay, well, if you're starting to get shot, you can't get any movement on one side. Send two of your teammates around and create a distraction, probably pull attention away from that location. Exactly. And send the enemy the message, hey, we're now coming around this direction. The problem, though, is with a team like Rain, we've seen them perform already in four different matches tonight, and we've seen them perform in the past, and they're just patient. You know, it is unlikely if Scrub Squad were to take that approach where they split two off and try to draw attention on the opposite side of the plane, it is unlikely that Rain would have been like, oh, well, now they're coming from over there. No, I think they're seasoned enough to understand, especially in league play, no, we're going to hold our ground. We're going to be patient. We're going to trust each other. Whoever is going to be watching that side has got it covered. If they need help, they're going to call for it. So I think in this particular case, Scrub Squad was just out-positioned.
They've got to know by now, though, that the other squad is using Eagle Eye. It may not hurt to actually split up a little bit more just to maybe add a little bit more confusion. If you've got four guys that are a little bit more split up than usual while using Eagle Eye, that guy's got so much intel to throw at his squad, he's going to either have to split up his squad or he's got no good intel. So maybe another approach.
That's a very good point. And speaking of Eagle Eye, that has been used so frequently, and for all the skills that have been added to this game, I would say that is probably the one that is most readily used in league play.
Absolutely. It is a little bit surprising to me, because just in normal gameplay, most of my guys never bring that stuff, and if they do, we make fun of them for it.
Look at you, bring an eagle eye.
Are you scared?
Oh, you want to know where your enemy is? Oh.
Your poor baby.
And of all maps to pick, we have Fob here. Hellraven going down right quick by Buckaroo, getting a quick elimination, starting it off strong, already giving his team one up. Titch goes down while he goes covering that alley. Now it's a 4v2.
Oh, behind me!
Rain is taking some hits from his sixth, but they got the kill.
Karen going down, quick elimination, and DMRP, the last member alive, has four members of Rain to eliminate here.
All right, what do we got?
I can almost guarantee that this was a map picked by Rain. I can't imagine Scrub Squad picking FOB as one of their choices.
Sorry, we're going to have to stop the game. Eroticus just came on, and I want to give him a shout-out. So, hey, Eroticus. Love you, buddy. Proceed on with the game.
love his comment.
He loves my hot voice. I hadn't even turned it on yet, baby. Ooh. Ooh. Turn the lights down.
You like this.
Yes.
You know it's over,
yeah, don't move in case they
so
got practice.
Sandy and fog.
My throat's a bit dry. Need some hydration.
Rain with another win.
And another ace, just racking up the points now. Score 4-1, four aces in favor of Rain. Scrub Squad still falling far behind with only one victory. Their only saving grace is to get three more wins, all being aces, which is kind of unlikely at this point, but that will at least close the gap significantly and give them the points that they need to go up on the leaderboard. Because currently, so the stats I was reading before were week four stats. I do have more updated stats. I don't know why I can't find the picture that I supposedly saved. So that's missing somewhere in my files and probably taking up space. But Killer Bees are currently sitting in first still with 105. Scrub Squad and Rain are in 10th and 5th, respectively. But Scrub Squad only with 40 points compared to Rain 76. I mean, that's a significant point differentiation. I mean, it's just 36 points is a lot to try to catch up to. And right now, tonight is not doing them any favors.
Yeah, I think being a pessimist is not very good. Glass could be half full on this. I mean, Scrub could take the remaining of the match and all aces, but
they're still going to lose by one. And
no, they're going to lose big time. My bad. You're totally right. Just ignore what I just said. This glass is almost empty, and let's just bury it and put it to bed.
Yeah. I mean, at this point in any kind of league match, and, you know, I say this even when I'm playing, and I even tell my team this sometimes, and it's not a negative statement, but it's a reframing or refocusing your objective. If you're down this far in a match and you're like, okay, well, the only option we have right now, based on our performance, is to limit the number of points they get, that is what your goal is going to be. With the fact that Rain has won every single one of their wins has been an ace, One of the goals right now by the Scrub Squad should be to at least eliminate one person and limit the number of points actually.
Minimum, yeah. Look, I know when my squad was playing up against Killaby. Cream Brulee. I'm sorry, Cream Brulee.
Another good team.
I mean, deep down, we'll never say it to their face. This doesn't count. But all we wanted to do is just, like, win two. And we just wanted to make sure we killed at least one person per round. We already knew, you know, I mean, you could have bent us over the table without even asking. We already knew what was going to happen. So it's just one of those things. You know, I was going to mention, though, really quick before this game starts up, that Fob might have been a pretty good choice. If you know you're going up against a squad that has the shooters, the guys that can get you on those crazy angles, why not throw some sand in their face? Take away the long visuals, and maybe you've gotten better up-close game against that team. So to me, Fob was actually a pretty good choice. It's a shitty round for me because of the visuals.
Mm-hmm.
That might have been a good play because of that. Even though they didn't win, it wasn't successful. It was still an up-close match, that last match.
Sure. Yeah, that strategy is still a reasonable and realistic strategy. You know, I often don't take that in consideration, but that is a very valid point.
I wouldn't say solar at all. I would say back this way.
Braden starting off their defense on the backside of the round where the Humvees are parked.
Not in the corner either, but
I love that spot.
It's like, yeah, this. I would do exactly what they're doing. Run to the solar panels, go meet them up in the middle, and just shoot this shit out.
We let them, yeah.
It's funny because this is exactly where they were stationed in the last round.
It is, yeah. This is where it all went down. I mean, I know they won, but this is. I don't know. They're covering it pretty well. There's not a lot of little hidden spots there. And they're split up, too. They're watching all angles. So that's pretty good. Pretty good little setup. Shooting from the tower.
Walls are getting a couple of downs along with Buckaroo.
Throw more grenades.
Slowly but surely, Scrub Squad's getting chopped down and away. Karen and Titch, last members alive. For the Scrub Squad, Rain holding down Fort, as they have been all night.
Looks like Scrub Squad is repositioning themselves, getting away from that tower.
So despite them dominating, they're still being very patient, telling each other, don't rush, don't rush. Rogue's getting a down on Titch. Wally goes down. There's a double down as Ak gets that double down. But very quickly, he too is eliminated, and that's another... Wow, look at that picture. Someone take a snapshot.
I was going to say, it's kind of pretty.
That's a good shot.
It's
totally
really
unintentional. but I like to hear the comms sometimes, particularly in a situation like that, where you have Rain, who is clearly dominating the round, and you could see Buckaroo was getting eager. He wanted to get those final eliminations. Like, there's two guys left where we're clearly... beating them, like, why not just go for it? And you have the rest of his team saying, no, they know where we are, we're going around. They haven't deviated from their strategy. They're still very focused, and they know that one or two people can effectively win a match.
Yeah, look, I am the Buckaroo of the group. When there's two or even one left, let's go get their asses. It's killing time, you know. Four on two is fun. But that has bit me in the ass multiple times before. So I do agree with the squad. Keep your patience. It has paid off for five rounds in a row so far. So, good play, good team, really tight. Love Rain.
Right now, the poll says one vote for Scrub Squad, one vote for Rain. Guys, if you don't know about the polls, there is a poll down below in the panels. If you're on mobile, it should be in the about section or the extensions. You should be able to see it in the extensions. Be sure to cast your vote. I'm sure, you could cast your vote and be like, yeah, I voted for Rain. Look at that. Because they technically won. But be sure, in the future, if you have not polled before, I try to make sure there's one up every single time. I try to do it before the round actually starts. Today I was a little bit late, but got in there nonetheless. And while you're down there, check out all the other stuff that we got going on. We are partnered with the Pro League and Gaming Synergy. If you guys ever want to run your own tournaments or run your own leagues, run it through Gaming Synergy. It is a fantastic website that does all the calculating for you, all the organizing for you. It's a fantastic system. It's run by Demolition Sean. You can contact him through the Pro League or through the Gaming Synergy Discords, which both of those will link you to. Check out Raise Energy by Rep Sports. They are our sponsor, a commission-based sponsor. If you go to their website, if you like nutritional supplements, or if you just want a different kind of energy drink, I can tell you, I have to wait a little bit to get my Raise Energy sometimes, but it is well worth the wait. All the flavors are delicious. I absolutely love them. Unfortunately, they only distribute to the U.S., so to anyone who is outside the States, I do apologize. But maybe if you're interested, if you really want to give it a shot, I can figure out a way to get it shipped to you. Check out all our other socials. We got Discord, Facebook, Twitter. Yes, we have a Twitter, YouTube, and our main website. Anyway, back into the game. Looks like we are over on District.
Beautiful Love District. Contact already.
Can I kill these guys?
Yeah.
Like Rogues went down as well, but not without taking a couple with him.
They are just a completely different approach on this time. Two members of Rain are down.
Oh, another one here too. Yeah, right in there. Yep, you got him. Maybe to your right wall.
Wow. Rose is eliminated by Kieran.
Nice. Yeah, boy. Yeah. Scrub Squad being Scrub. But they at least got an elimination
firewall.
On someone on Rain's team, so
that
takes away the ace from them. Only two members left to get the laptop. 40 seconds remaining in this round.
God, that was a quick round, wasn't it?
Yeah, it looks like Scrub Squad just said screw it, you know. let's just take a different approach and get a couple eliminations here.
At least they stopped the ace. I mean, that's, again, when we were taken up against Spring Blue Lake, we just wanted to win a couple of rounds. Main thing was is let's kill them at least once, every round, one person at least each round, so we don't get that ace on us. So I'm happy for Scrub. They stopped that ace, stopped that trend. So good for them.
Yeah. Especially coming off of a match like last week. You know, I had talked to Titch about this before. You know, I got to go back to the listings again, because their season started off very challenging. Just in general. Why is that broken? Why does that keep being broken for me? They went up against a lot of the top teams already right off the get. Are you going to open now? No? Okay. Well, it doesn't want to open now. Here it is.
While you're figuring that out, Eroticus, Chuck is... Which one was he? Was he playing... What are we playing here? Is this NA or Pro?
this is Pro League. Yep.
Yeah, so this is why I was calling Chuck the whore of tournaments, because he's not in this tournament tonight, because he's in the other tournament with the other league tonight. So... He's like a doorknob, and everybody got a turn.
And he either does it for free or he pays people.
Yeah, but I do highly recommend, if anybody has the time, to go to Eroticus's YouTube page. Lots and lots of great, great videos on there, especially the one that reads Bingham Banter.
Oh, let's do it.
That is a beautiful video, and Walzer, I do appreciate Eroticus for making it.
Are you any good at holding this upper right Eagle's eye?
So, yeah, if we look at Scrub Squad's week by week, they had the Toons in the second week, then they had Meat Pack in week 4, they had Killabees in week 5, and now they have Rain in week 6. That's 4 of their 6 games. Top teams.
Yeah, that is exactly what I was saying earlier. This is if you get that tough early schedule, this is where you're going to look like on the score round, but on up against the other squads. Give them another week or two, and you'll start seeing Scrub Squad go up, and basically anchor their place in this tournament.
Good positioning by Rain, holding the parking lot. I love this position. And I like how Walzer's out in the middle, applying pressure deep into the middle of the map. This is a good opportunity to sit forward, apply that pressure early, and then retreat if necessary, because they got a lot of room to move.
Totally agree. And Rain is taking some hits right now, so he's getting some cover. But yeah, I agree. This is a great defense spot.
Titch goes down by Rogues. Good trade.
Oh, wow.
While he was trying to get the revive, Titch gets hit by a grenade, and Ak also goes down, so only 2 members left on the Scrub Squad.
It's rough luck.
All right, getting Buckaroo down from outside the market.
I'm very dead.
Oh, no.
I fucked it.
Well, let's play defense. Let's get out of this hallway. We've got multiple angles to watch in this hallway.
Well, we had 2 coming through the back, guys. I don't know.
So the ace is eliminated. I think I did see Buckaroo did it get eliminated. Is that correct?
Yep, Buckaroo is down. It's now 2v3.
Okay.
With Hell Rain and DMRP for Scrub Squad.
Hey, do you have eyes on him, bro?
Yeah, no, one's going in the back.
Do you have eyes on the car? In the back. Do you have eyes?
And it looks like they're going to try to go for a pinch here with DMRP out towards the parking lot. Double firing down that hall there is Walzer and Rogues. Wally down in DMRP, leaving Hellrain, the last remaining member, who has also been eliminated, and that's it. It looks like
is the game.
It's all good.
Rain gets the final win.
That's the only reason I pushed out after the grenade hit.
7-1 with 5 aces. That is a tough, tough match.
5 aces, I think.
That is a good victory for Rain. That's going to bump them up. They're currently sitting in 5th place with 76 points. What is that, 26 extra points there?
Right, yeah.
So that's going to effectively put them into the top 4, at least until the other teams play their matches this week. But really good look for them this week, for sure.
Both teams really good, did good plays, still have strong players, just not tonight. It just wasn't their night tonight. But Rain came in through with that strong win. And I think it does show everyone who is watching that if you do have patience and you do have a good squad that communicates, even the one that wants to run off, which would be me, and the squad will actually talk to you and communicate and say, no, come on back and work on the same page, you get these type of results. So Rain really, really earned it tonight. They did a great job.
Yeah, both teams fought hard. Scrub Squad, unfortunately, falling to Rain in a very tough fight. Pretty good exchanges there. I think, just unfortunately, you know, for Scrub Squad, Rain, they had better positioning. They had better shots, just yep. overall. I think the map positioning that they had gave them the advantage that they needed. And as you had said, I'm going to reiterate, communication was... was really good. I mean, they just naturally outperformed. So very good for Rain. Fortunate for Scrub Squad, but both teams played really well. Thank you guys so much for that match. Best of luck to both teams. Still got plenty of season left here in the Pro League, so be sure to tune in for the upcoming matches. If you have not followed already, be sure to hit that heart icon and hit that bell and select all. That way you're notified every time we do go live. And I want to thank Rad again for coming out two nights in a row, man.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
That's absolutely awesome. Do you have anything you want to say before we head on out?
I do. I just want to say thanks to the Firewall brothers and sisters who are watching tonight. Love every one of y'all and your comments, even the jackass ones. And want to thank the AHC gods who actually do all this stuff. Raptors behind the scenes right now doing this shit like he's been doing this shit for years. So I want to thank Raptor and Timber and all the other AHC gods who gave me this invite two nights in a row. So lucky me. But hopefully I could see a little bit more. Who knows?
Rad's Girl Friday. Good job, babe.
Good job, baby.
Well, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Really appreciate it. Again, hit that heart icon to follow and be sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time we go live. Check out the panels below. Be sure to join all the socials. We do update them regularly. It's also a good opportunity to get to know us as a group. Also get to know the community that has been loving and supportive over the past year. So really appreciate that. And be sure to check out our merchandise store. Every time I go live, I'm always wearing some merch. This is one of our hoodies. Be sure to check that out if you guys want to support us that way. Or check out our sponsor if you guys want to try a new energy drink. AHC promo code gives you 15% off. But that's going to be it for me. This was the Pro League North American Division match between Rain and Scrub Squad. Until next time, folks. Peace.
Peace. Find